Talk show, I'm your host Dominic George. The East Circuit, here we are. We've just spoken about emotional abuse and how emotional abuse can affect your marriage. Now we want to spread the love with the Spread the Love initiative. And I've got two guests on my show today. And you know what I do is celebrating young people who are using their youth to make a difference. And today I have two guests. We are going to be, there's a lady who's coming in a few. But in the meantime, let's start with what we've got right now, with whom we've got right now. And I've got my guest, and I'm going to start with the farthest, which corner is this? Right, yes.
Right.
Come, yeah. So introduce yourself.
Hello, everyone. My name is James Miner, and I'm one of the founders of Spread the Love Initiative.
Oh, Spread the Love. You are one of the founders. You know what's interesting about you?
Yeah.
One of my brothers is called James Miner, so this is fantastic. All right. So I've got a brother right there.
Yeah.
And who is my brother from another mother?
Yes, your brother from another mother is Maurice Mule Musyoka.
Maurice Mule Musyoka.
Yes.
What's your name? No.
Ni sawa.
Weova?
Yeah, Nova.
No, Kenya?
Yes.
Siju kama nilikama bebe.
Yeah, nimefika.
All right. So, Spread the Love Initiative.
Yes.
You are the founders.
Yeah.
Right.
So who told who, let's found the Spread the Love Initiative? Or it was just during a conversation and this thing came up?
I guess it was me.
Mm-hmm.
I did approach him, and I told him that we should visit a children's home.
Okay.
Yeah. But he had no idea why I was telling him to visit a children's home. So when we went, before we went, his mom gave us some codes, which we took there. And when we went to the children's home, Maxima Miracle Center, children's home in Kahawaskari.
Maxima Miracle Children's Center, where is that?
It is in Kahawaskari.
Ah, Kahawaskari, okay.
Because that's when we formed Initiative Said. It was in February.
February.
Yeah.
February 2014, you said?
2014.
So what was the main motivation? What was the main motivation?
As he said, it was in February.
Mm-hmm.
February is a very significant month.
Ah,
it's the month of love.
Mwezi wa mapenzi.
Yeah. Na nikiongeza hiyo, I'm a Scorpio.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, my star, my horoscope. See,
yes.
Ni watu wa mapenzi.
Uh-huh.
So he challenged me. I asked myself, right, what are we doing as the youth? You know, we have this stuff. When my mom came up with the clothing, nilifikiria nikajiuliza, hizi nguo zinafanya nini mtaani? What can we do? Then he came with the idea. We visited the home, and it was a very nice feeling, you know, giving somebody who really needed something. Kitu ulikuwa unadhani haina maana, upeleke mse, uone amefurahi, you know. Those kids were very excited because it was a random thing.
You just showed up.
Yeah, we decided we are going, we went, manze, we had githeri that day.
Okay.
Yeah.
The kids,
it was very nice.
We crashed in front.
Oh, tulidoya lunch.
Tulidoya lunch, manze. Ilikuwa lunch time.
Food ya watoi.
Lakini unajua sasa kuna watoi.
You're not spreading some love, you're spreading some love.
Unajua pia chakula wa gatamu mkikula wewe.
That's important. That's good. So, was it because it was in February that you decided you're going to call it the Spread Some Love?
It just came, okay. As for me, my story was different.
Mm-hmm.
I was in depression for a very long time, and when I overcame it, I thought it would be wise if I share what I learned through that period with someone else, because I don't want anyone to go through the same situation I had to go through.
Yeah.
So that was the main pillars why I had to tell him, so that we could make it a bigger picture, and also come with something solid that we leave to help many people.
You know,
more so the less.
Let me just interrupt you. You mentioned something very important.
Yeah, yeah.
Something that many people would not admit.
Yeah, yeah.
About mental health.
Yeah, yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Depression. Right. Yeah. So you said you were in depression.
Yeah, yeah. Well,
how long were you in depression, if you may ask?
For 1 year.
That was
way back in 2012.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I hope maybe sometime we might share why you went to depression when you're ready, because I don't want to put you in the spot.
That's a story for another day.
For another time.
Yeah. Yes.
2 years and counting.
Yes.
How has the experience been?
The experience so far has been wonderful.
Uh-huh.
Yes, there are hitches here and there, but as a Christian, I believe that love is the greatest. You know, it's the greatest of all commandments. And I believe all over the world, even in any other religion, everybody believes in love, and love is the answer. So even though there are challenges, we are strong because of love. We want to spread that love.
That's absolutely great.
Yeah.
So how many people are you right now? How many people have joined your team right now?
We are many. We are a movement.
We are a movement. We have almost 500 people.
500
coming
people.
Coming
yes.
each
year. Wow. That is absolutely brilliant.
Right.
Yeah. I mean, 2014 to now 500 people and
yeah.
counting.
Yeah.
So what do they usually do, these 500 people?
Okay, what we normally do is that we are different from other initiatives because
mm-hmm.
we don't focus on material things. Because a time will come when you will take things to a student's home and they will tell you, we have it. What
yeah.
will you give them apart from that?
Okay.
Because yeah. if you give them soap, at one day it will finish up. So what we do, we focus with words. We focus with your inner beauty. Because I believe advising someone is a mission that requires no qualification at all. So our main aim, when we visit a children's home, one is given a kid, which they're supposed to stay with that kid until the end of the event. So you're also given like 1 hour where you go with the kid and sit separately and you start talking. Because
mm-hmm.
many other times when you go to a children's home, you'll separate yourselves.
Mm-hmm.
Visitors will sit on this on one side and the host on the
yes,
other
it's
side.
Yes, it's true.
And
yeah.
you, the kids will go there, they will entertain you, and then after that, you will hand over your
some gifts and then you go take photos.
Uh-huh.
But you don't, many people don't talk to those kids.
Oh, yeah.
yeah
they
because,
don't create
yeah,
a personal relationship.
Because yeah, we as human beings, we believe that their main problem is that they are lacking something that they can touch.
They can, yeah, someone
but
they can
most
hold
of them, they need hope.
True.
So we focus much on injecting some hope and some inspiration in them.
That's really good.
Yeah.
So like how many children's home do you like visit in a month, or how do you arrange this?
We don't do that. We try to do it often, but we have one main one. We usually do every February. We celebrate our anniversary at Ebenezer Children's Home. It's in Githurai 45, Mumbi.
So like Ebenezer is like now your base?
Yeah, that's where we started.
Uh-huh.
That's where we celebrate it.
That's where you go more
yes,
often?
Yes, but we visit other children's home.
Okay.
We've been to Toto Children's Home in Kasarani.
Okay.
In House of Mercy.
House of Mercy. So
yeah.
like this month, September, what's the plan?
September, we are doing a
hike.
Charity hike.
Yeah,
charity hike. Where?
Yes, in at Ngong Hills.
Next
Saturday,
week?
Yeah.
Where?
Ngong Hills. Yeah.
So anyone who is watching and wants to join the charity hike Ngong Hills this Saturday, you said? The coming
yes.
Saturday?
Yeah.
So they're welcome to join the Spread the Love
yes,
initiative.
Yeah, welcome. Very welcome.
Okay,
yeah,
before we take a short break, I want us to like talk a few things. I want to ask you a question and then we'll take a break.
Right.
When you are doing these things, when you are reaching out to children's home, when you are going out to visit these people who are in need,
mm-hmm.
what does this do for you as a person? What do you feel as a person? Do you feel that something changes for you? Do you feel like you are better, that you are happier, that your life is more meaningful? I don't know. What do you think? How has it helped you, like for you, to get out of the depression, if you want to say?
I think the best thing is when you go to a children's home for the very first time, they treat you as strangers.
Mm-hmm.
But when you go for the second time, and you see those kids running and coming towards you and hugging you, and then the bond becomes strong. I think that's the best feeling.
Absolutely.
Yeah, and when you sit down and you try to catch up from since last time, and you notice that there's some improvement, even the way the kids reason, the way kids get to view life in general, you feel awesome.
You
as
feel
for
good.
Me,
yeah.
if I don't do charity, I don't feel complete.
That's
so
nice
when I do
good.
That, I feel so good. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Seeing a person walking with that kid in the path of inspiration.
That's good.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
it just kills me.
What about you? What does it do for you?
They say a day without a smile is a day wasted.
Yeah.
There's nothing that gives me more joy and satisfaction than seeing that kid smile.
Absolutely.
Doing something for them, even if it's not giving them something materialistic, seeing them smile satisfies me.
True.
And the fact that I can inspire and give somebody hope.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Right, that is just it for me.
Fantastic.
Yes.
I mean, it's for me, I'm always so overjoyed when I see young people who are making a difference, young
right.
who are out there, not just waiting to be given, waiting to receive, waiting to follow my dreams, but also trying to help some other people achieve their dreams.
Mm-hmm.
And today I celebrate you. We're going to have a short break and then we're going to come back and speak about how more we can encourage more young people to get more into that, okay? So
yeah.
the DJ is going to play some music for us
yeah.
and we're going to have a short break. Don't go away. We're going to be back.